Hi, I'm Brian Cornes, Aerospace Market Director at MTS. AeroPro Software provides a tightly integrated control and data acquisition interface with unmatched control loop optimization tools to accelerate even the most complex high-channel tests. MTS is constantly improving AeroPro with new features that make software easier to use, improve test article safety, provide new and better data visibility and integration, and improve test times that yield faster test results. In this ongoing series, we'll demonstrate some of these key AeroPro features. In today's session, we are joined by Michael Dembinski, one of MTS's many system integration engineers. Mike is going to demonstrate a new AeroPro feature called Video Display that allows you to integrate and display video cameras into the test software. Users can overlay lines and shapes in the video, making it easy to capture test article movements. Take it away, Mike.
Hi there, I'm Michael Dembinski, and today we're going to be looking at the video display within the data display application. When you add the ability to have the video display and the video interface, you're going to get a couple more sections in your AeroPro test configuration window. We can see over in the system resources that we now have a section for cameras, and these are the actual hardware resources, the cameras that you have connected to the system. We're able to pull these over into our test configuration into the new video channels section. When you have these pulled over into the test configuration and you're loaded to a station, we're able to open up data display, connect to the runtime, and open up a live recording of the video. So I'm going to open up a video display, and I'm going to select the very first video signal. And we can see the live feed of that camera. And that camera is this camera right here. On video display, we have the option to add in a couple of different things. We can add in overlays on top of the video itself, such as line, circle, rectangle, or a label. And the nice thing about these different overlays is that as we move the video display around or resize it, it'll automatically move around and resize with that video display itself. We also have the ability to have multiple video displays at once. So I can open up another video display here, and I can even select multiple signals. So now I'm going to select video channel 1 and video channel 3. Add that into this video display. And as you can see a repeat of that video. We're pulling over video 1 right now. But if I use the page up and page down keys, I can switch to the other signals within that display. So since I have video 3 here, now we're showing video 3. When you are recording data, it's also going to record the video as well and allow you to go into the post-test and play back that video along with all the data that you recorded. I had recorded some data previously as well as some video, and the data that I had recording was some virtual data acquisition channels that were running just sine waves. I'm going to pull open the post-test right now, and that's what I have in this group, and I'm going to add in a plot for some of those sine wave data on those virtual channels. So I'm going to pull in one of the data acquisition channels. We'll have that plotted on here. And then I'm also going to pull open a video display that'll pull open the video that was being recorded while this data was being taken. And I'm going to select one of the video channels within that recording. I'll select video 1. And we can see it pulls open the frame from that very first data signal. We have the option to have playback over here on the left, and I can do things such as play the video. And as I play the video, it'll automatically start playing through the data at the same time. I can stop the video. I can also frame forward and frame backward, as well as skip forward and skip back. We can also go to a particular sample by going up here. I can go back to the very first sample, and it'll go back to that sample in the data, as well as the frame of the recording from when that data sample is taken. I can go to the 1,000th sample, and it'll bring up the appropriate frame in the appropriate portion of the data. And I can choose to play back right from here. We also have the option to have everything that we had in the live recording as well, all those overlay options that we talked about previously, line, circle, and what have you. And we can play back with those overlays on there. And that's the video display and the data display application. Thanks for tuning in.
Thanks for watching. Please check out our other videos and MTS webpage for more information. If you are interested in leveraging these features, please reach out to your local rep about an AeroPro upgrade or training. MTS is committed to improving the AeroPro user experience and welcomes your feedback. Please contact us if you have ideas for new features. Thanks, and see you next time.